everybody. My name is Gabby, and thank you guys so much for joining me for another video for The Guide, my YouTube channel. Yay! So I was not gonna make a YouTube video this week. Like, I had just made it up in my brain that it was not going to happen this week, and that I was perfectly okay with that. And then yesterday morning happened. I woke up and immediately my heart was racing, my mind was going 100 miles per minute, my stomach was in knots. I mean, it was literally like my entire body was experiencing chaos. And in my brain, there was a bunch of questions that were going through my brain that I did not know the answers to. And immediately I felt worry, I felt anxiety, I felt fear. And I literally had just opened my eyes. Like, I don't even think I had been awake for a minute, and this is what I was experiencing. And unfortunately, this was not the first time, the second or the third time that this has happened to me. It actually happens very, very often. And if you are like me, you understand this feeling. You understand waking up and going through the motions of this. And maybe you don't experience it very often, but maybe you have experienced it. Maybe you're experiencing it more often now that you are in college, or you're getting ready to go on your way to college. Or maybe you're making the transition as a senior out of college life. Maybe there are things worrying you about how you're going to pay your student loans back, if you're going to get the job that you want. Maybe there are things going on at home. Maybe there are things going on in your own home, maybe in your dorm, that is worrying you or causing you anxiety or causing you fear. And I'm here to say that even myself, I have not mastered how to deal with this. But I do want to talk about what happened after experiencing that. And to go back to the story, I was sitting in my bed continuing to feel this chaos going on in my body and in my mind. And I stopped and said, you know what? I am not going to let this destroy my day. Because in the past, I let anxiety and fear and worry literally destroy things before I even got there. Whether it was a presentation where I knew the information and I completely bombed it because I couldn't get through it because I was so worried about what other people were thinking. Maybe it was an idea or a gift that God had given me that I couldn't get through it, or I never even talked about it or said anything about it because I was afraid that it wasn't going to go perfectly and it wasn't going to go the way that I thought that it should go. I mean, fear and anxiety and worry, it has really kind of stopped and become a cripple in my life. And yesterday I made a choice. I made a decision to not let it destroy my day, to not let it destroy my week, to not worry about Thursday, to not worry about next week, to not worry about the end of the semester, to not worry about the next 2 or 3 years of my life, but to understand and to trust that God has already been in my tomorrow. He's already seen everything that's going to happen in my life, and that all things will and have, even in the past, worked together for my good. And that's what I have to stand on and trust. I gave all of my fears and all of my worries to God yesterday. And I'm not gonna say that as soon as I did that, the thoughts never popped up and I never had any more issues, and you know, I didn't have to kind of constantly tell myself during the day, it's okay, God has you. I did have to do that. But the moment that I made that decision, things opened up for me. Things got a little bit better for me. My day was saved because I made that choice to not be under the weight of everything else that I had to do. So I really wanted to make this video to encourage you guys. Maybe this is you. Maybe you have been fighting and dealing with anxiety and worry and fear. Maybe this is something that has recently happened because of recent events in your life. And I'm here to tell you to give it to God. Make a choice to not let it destroy your day, not let it destroy your tomorrow before you even get there. Just making that choice really just, it lifted a weight off of me. And I think it was one of the first times that I had really said to myself, not today. No, we're not going to do this today. And it made such a difference in how I carried myself for the rest of the day and how I thought about things. And I just want to leave you guys with this, Philippians 4, 6 through 7. And it says, do not fret or have any anxiety about anything, but in every circumstance and in everything, by prayer and petition, definite request with thanksgiving, continue to make your wants known to God. And God's peace shall be yours, that tranquil state of a soul assured of its salvation through Christ. And so fearing nothing from God and being content with its earthly lot or whatever sort that is, that peace which transcends all understanding shall mount and guard over your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. So again, give whatever it is that you're feeling, whatever events, whatever issues it is, give it to God, because I promise you that He will show up and He will just cloud your mind and your body with peace. And like the scripture said, in a tranquil state. That's what you want. You want to be at peace and you want to be in a tranquil state. So again, if you're like me, you're dealing with anxiety, worry, fear, give it to God. Make a choice today to not let anxiety destroy your day, your tomorrow, and your years to come. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope that was helpful, and I will see you guys on the next one. Bye.